Hello everyone, welcome to yet another fabulous episode of Joel's Bible Days. Sorry about those noises, I think those are notifications or something. Anyways, welcome to the season finale of Joel's Bible Days. I know, it's heartbreaking. I'll miss this season because I've had a lot of fun on it, so yeah. Anyways, I got a few announcements, so let's get on with it and then we'll be doing Bible reading. Number one, my mom won't guest star today, so... Yeah, she was kind of sick, so... Yeah, I'm sorry about that, but I'll have her guest star soon. Number two. I'm going to Wyoming tomorrow. That's why I'm posting it today on Thursday. It'll be, like I've said before, season three will be, like, 1 week after the season two finale, which is now. But, because I'll be in Wyoming. But I'll be posting, like, probably in 2 or maybe 3 weeks, so... Yeah, so that's why I'm posting it today. And number three, I will be skipping some chapters in the Bible, and that is because, there's some chapters that aren't as interesting as, Genesis and Exodus, which I have been reading for a year now. So, yeah, I just wanted to, go to the, really interesting part, so you guys will be interested to learn, about this. So, yeah. Anyways, besides that, it was my dad's 41st birthday yesterday, so happy birthday from yesterday, Dad. I pulled a really funny prank, but I probably won't mention it, yeah. Anyways, let's praise the Lord our God, and then we'll get started with another episode. Dear God, thank you for another wonderful day we can learn about you. Thank you that we can trust you. Thank you for being our Lord. Thank you for being the Messiah, the Savior, Jesus of Nazareth. Thank you for all you do for us. Thank you for all your sacrifices, like dying on the cross. I also pray that my brother Chase continues to have no more seizures. I pray that people having COVID-19, that they'll feel better soon. And I also pray that people in a bad time right now or having COVID-19, that they'll feel better. And I pray that COVID goes away soon. In Jesus' name, amen. COVID isn't officially over, but it's mostly over. I mean, like you don't have to wear masks as much places. I'm sure a lot of you have experienced that. So, yeah, I've been really excited not to wear masks so many places. So, yeah, anyways, let's jump into our Bibles to Exodus chapter 39. We'll be reading chapter 40 later, the final chapter of Exodus. And then, well... That's it. So, yeah. Anyways, let's do this. If you don't have a Bible, then please turn on your captions if you can on this episode. But anyways, please turn to your Bible to Exodus chapter 9. Anyways, here is chapter 39. Making the priestly garments. From the blue and purple and scarlet yarns, they made finely woven garments for ministering in the holy place. They made the holy garments for Aaron, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He made the ephod of gold, blue, and purple, and scarlet yarns, and fine twined linen. And they hammered out gold leaf, and he cut it into threads to work into the blue and purple and the scarlet yarns, and into the fine twined linen in skilled design. They made for the ephod attaching shoulder pieces, joined to it as its two edges, and skillfully woven band on it was of one piece with it and made like it, of gold, blue, and purple, and scarlet yarns, and fine twined linen, as the Lord had commanded Moses. They made the onyx stones enclosed in settings of gold filigree, and engraved like the engravings of a signet, according to the names of the sons of Israel. And he set them on the shoulder pieces of the ephod to be stones of remembrance for the sons of Israel, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He made the breastpiece in skilled work in the style of the ephod or ephod of gold, blue, and purple, and scarlet yarns, and fine twined linen. It was square. They made the breastpiece doubled, a span its length and a span its breadth when doubled. Ooh, that's interesting.
And they set it in four rows of stones. A row of sardius, topaz, and carbuncle was the first row. And the second row, an emerald, a sapphire, and a diamond. And the third row, a jacinth, an agate, I think it's an agate or agate, and an amethyst. And the fourth row, a beryl, an onyx, and a jasper. They were closed in settings of gold filigree. There were 12 stones with their names according to the names of the sons of Israel. They were like signets, each engraved with its name for the 12 tribes. And they made on the breastpiece twisted chains like cords of pure gold. And they made two settings of gold filigree and two gold rings. And put the two rings on the two edges of the breastpiece.
Ugh, stop it.
Ugh. So none. Sorry about that. Just ignore that. Anyways, verse 17. And they put out the two cords of gold and the two rings at the edges of the breastpiece. They attached the two ends of the two cords to the two settings of filigree. Thus they attached it in front to the shoulder pieces of the ephod. By the way, if you want to look up the words from where I'm reading, including Exodus chapter 40, then I probably won't be doing that much today because, I got a lot of verses to read today. But anyways, continuing on verse 19, then they made the two rings of gold and put them at the two ends of the breastpiece on its inside edge next to the ephod. And they made two rings of gold and attached them in front to the lower part of the two shoulder pieces of the ephod, and its seam above the skillfully woven band of the ephod, or ephod. And they bound the breastpiece by its rings to the rings of the ephod with a lace of blue, so that it should lie on the skillfully woven band of the ephod, and that the breastpiece should not come loose from the ephod, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He also made the robe of the ephod woven in, olive blue. And the opening of the robe in it was like the opening in a garment, with a binding around the opening so that it might not tear. On the hem of the robe that they made pomegranates of blue and purple and scarlet yarns and fine twined linen. They also made bells of pure gold and put the bells between the pomegranates all around the hem of the robe between the pomegranates. A bell and a pomegranate, a bell and a pomegranate around the hem of the robe for ministering, as the Lord had commanded Moses. They also made the coats woven of fine linen for Aaron and his sons, and the turban of fine linen, and the caps of fine linen, and the linen undergarments of fine twined linen, and the sash of fine twined linen, and of blue and purples and scarlet yarns embroidered with needlework, as the Lord had commanded Moses. They made the plate of the holy crown of pure gold and wrote on it an inscription like the engraving of a signet, in quotations, "Holy to the Lord." And they tied to it a cord of blue to fasten it on the turban above, as the Lord had commanded Moses. Thus all the work of the tabernacle of the tent of meeting was finished, and the people of Israel did according to all that the Lord had commanded Moses. So they did. Then they brought the tabernacle to Moses, the tent and all its utensils, its hooks, its frames, its bars, its pillars, and its bases, the covering of tanned ram skins and goat skins, and the veil of the screen, and the ark of the testimony with its poles, and the mercy seat, the table with all its utensils, and the bread of the presence, the lampstand of pure gold, and its lamps with the lamps set, and all its utensils, and the oil for the light, the golden altar, the anointing oil, and the fragrant incense, and the screen for the entrance of the tent, the bronze altar, and its grating of bronze, its poles, and all its utensils, the basin, and its stand, the hangings of the court, its pillars, and its bases, and the screen for the gate of the court, its cords, and its pegs, and all the utensils for the service of the tabernacle, for the tent of meeting, the finely worked garments, which are clothing for ministering in the holy place, the holy garments for Aaron the priest, and the garments of his sons for their service as priests, according to all that the Lord had commanded Moses. So the people of Israel had done all the work. And Moses saw all the work, and behold, they had done it. As the Lord had commanded, so they had done it. Then Moses blessed them.
Yay, wasn't that a nice chapter? I'm just going to look up what that chapter is about and read the question down in my Bible real quick. But I'll look up what it's all about first. Hey, Google. What is Exodus chapter 39 about? Oh, wait. Hey, Google. What is Exodus chapter 39 about?
On the website totallyhistory.com, they say, Exodus chapter 39 is the final chapter in the book that deals with the construction of the tabernacle and what God wanted to have inside it.
It tells of the garments Aaron and his sons were to wear, and Moses' inspection of it once it was completed. And one more thing, why did God show himself as pillars of fire and cloud? God used these two pillars as signs of his presence with his people as he led them out of Egypt. Day or night, God was with them. He used these pillars to protect them from the Egyptian armies. At the end of Exodus, the cloud of the Lord's glory filled the tabernacle again as a sign of God's presence and protection. Exodus, oh, wait, that's for chapter 40. Anyways, Exodus chapter 40, verses 34 to 38. Well, hopefully you remember that. But anyways, here is Exodus chapter 40. And again, if you don't have your Bible, if you don't have a Bible, then just listen to get to the captions if they're allowed. But anyways, here is chapter 40. The tabernacle erected. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, on the first day of the first month, you shall erect the tabernacle of the tent of meeting, and you shall put in it the ark of the testimony, and you shall screen the ark with the veil, and you shall bring in the table and arrange it, and you shall bring in the lampstand and set up its lamps. And you shall put the golden altar for incense before the ark of the testimony, and set up the screen for the door of the tabernacle. You shall set the altar of burnt offering before the door of the tabernacle of the tent of meeting, and place the basin between the tent of meeting and the altar, and put water in it. And you shall set up the court all around and hang up the screen for the gate of the court. Then you shall take the anointing oil and anoint the tabernacle and all that is in it, and consecrate it and all its furniture so that it may become holy. You shall also anoint the altar of burnt offering and all its utensils, and consecrate the altar, so that the altar may become most holy. You shall also anoint the basin and its stand, and consecrate it. Then you shall bring Aaron and his sons to the entrance of the tent of meeting, and shall wash them with water, and put on Aaron the holy garments, and you shall anoint him and consecrate him, that he may serve me as priest. You shall bring his sons also, and put coats on them, and anoint them as you anointed their father, that they may serve me as priests. And their anointing shall admit them to a perpetual priesthood throughout their generations. This Moses did according to all that the Lord commanded him. So he did. In the first month of the second year, on the first day of the month, the tabernacle was erected. Moses erected the tabernacle. He laid its bases and set up its frames and put in its poles and raised up its pillars. And he spread the tent over the tabernacle and put the covering of the tent over it, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He took the testimony and put it into the ark, and put the poles on the ark, and set the mercy seat above the ark. And he brought the ark into the tabernacle, and set up the veil on the screen, and screened the ark of the testimony, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He put the table in the tent of meeting on the north side of the tabernacle, outside the veil, and arranged the bread on it before the Lord, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He put the lampstand in the tent of meeting, opposite the table on the south side of the tabernacle, and set up the lamps before the Lord, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He put the golden altar in the tent of meeting before the veil, and the burnt fragrant incense
incense on it, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He put in place the screen for the door of the tabernacle, and he set the altar of burnt offering at the entrance of the tabernacle of the tent of meeting, and offered on it the burnt offering and the grain offering, as the Lord had commanded Moses. He set the basin between the tent of meeting and the altar, and put water in it for washing, with which Moses and Aaron and his sons washed their hands and their feet. When they went into the tent of meeting, and when they approached the altar, they washed, as the Lord commanded Moses. And he erected the court around the tabernacle and the altar, and set up the screen of the gate of the court. So Moses finished the work. The glory of the Lord. Then the cloud covered the tent of meeting, and the glory of the Lord filled the tabernacle. And Moses was not able to enter the tent of meeting, because the cloud settled on it, and the glory of the Lord filled the tabernacle. Throughout all their journeys, whenever the cloud was taken up from over the tabernacle, the people of Israel would set out. But if the cloud was not taken up, then they did not set out till the day that it was taken up. For the cloud of the Lord was on the tabernacle by day, and fire was in it by night, in the sight of all the house of Israel throughout all their journeys. Yay, wasn't that a nice worship? Wasn't that a nice chapter? As long as the other one. Well, anyway, since we still have time, I'm going to read that question again. I should have looked at that before I actually read that the last time. But anyways, I'm going to read it again. Why did God show himself as pillars of fire and cloud? God used these two pillars as signs of his presence with his people as he led them out of Egypt. Day or night, God was with them. He used these pillars to protect them from the Egyptian armies. At the end of Exodus, the cloud of the Lord's glory filled the tabernacle again as a sign of God's presence and protection. Exodus chapter 40, verses 34 to 38. So, anyways, that's it again. And anyways, this is the final worship song of the season. It's a fan favorite. It's probably my favorite worship song ever. I don't know. But it's definitely one of my favorites. It's House of the Lord, a new song by Phil Wickham, which was released earlier this year. But anyways, let's play it. Hey, Google, play Top...
Let me do it again. Top Remix by Fredo Bang. Sure.
Let me do this again. Hey, Google, play House of the Lord by Phil Wickham.
House of the Lord by Phil Wickham.
There we go.
Sure. Playing on YouTube Music.
And don't forget to turn on your captions and sing along with if the captions are bad. Anyways, make sure you sing along.
We worship the God who was. We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors. He parted the raging sea. My God, he holds the victory. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. And we won't be quiet. Shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is shining in this place. And we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. Oh, oh, oh. We shout out your praise. Oh, oh, oh. We sing to the God who heals. We sing to the God who saves. We sing to the God who always makes a way. Cause he hung up on that cross, then he rose up from that grave. My God's still rolling stones away. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. And we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. In the house of the Lord, our God is surely in royalty. We were the prisoners, now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. 'Cause we were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners, now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise.
Worship song. Can you see why I love the song? It worships God. It's just really beautiful to God. So that was the final worship song of this season. Anyways, let's read the final Psalms verses of this season, and we'll continue to do it. Here's Psalms chapter 106 verses 1-5, and don't worry, it'll go quickly. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. Praise the Lord, oh give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His steadfast love endures forever. Who can utter the mighty deeds of the Lord, or declare all His praise? Blessed are those who observe justice, who do righteousness at all times. Remember me, O Lord, when you show favor to your people. Help me when you save them, that I may look upon the prosperity of your chosen ones, that I may rejoice in the gladness of your nation, that I may glory in your inheritance. Yay, wasn't those nice verses? Well, anyways, those are the final worship songs and verses of this season, and we'll do more next time. And anyways, let's praise the Lord our God, and then we'll... Excuse me. Dear God, thank you for another wonderful day that you're here. Thank you that you made this earth so we could live. Thank you we are redeemed by your love, your grace. Thank you that you have mercy on us. Thank you for all the sacrifices. Thank you for being who you are, Lord, because you really are perfect. Like, we really need to look up to you because you sacrificed your life so we could live. I pray that my brother Chase continues to have no more seizures. I pray that people will love you forever. I just pray that everyone will glorify you. Lord, I pray that COVID-19 will officially go away soon. I pray that people having COVID-19 or in a bad time that they'll feel better soon. Amen. So, things are getting better in the world, so, yeah. Besides that, remember that, in 2 weeks I'll have, 2 or 3 weeks I'll have new episodes, and, yeah, so, what was the other thing? Let me just try to remember real quick. I'll be skipping some chapters because I want to, like, have the most interesting chapters so that you'll be interested in learning, like, the Bible. So, yeah. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the season finale. Season 3 will be back in just a few weeks. I can't wait for it, and I'll see you in a few weeks. Well, anyways, I hope you enjoyed this episode, and bye, and I'll see you next time. And besides that, please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet. Also, please don't forget to watch my full videos if you haven't yet, because we really should love God. Yeah, that's the best tip for life I have, and love God. Well, anyways, bye, and I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye, and, well, bye.